Imagine what would happen if suddenly I gave you a special drug that gave you the ability to learn any skill instantly. What would you learn first? And most importantly, what would you do with this ability to just suddenly be able to have any skill that you wanted? Well, in this video, I am going to not give you a drug like that because a drug like that doesn't exist. This is just some stupid face cream. But what I will give you is a step-by-step system to allow you to start learning difficult technical things much faster and to make understanding them easier and thus make it easier for you to apply these things in real life. The reason you're struggling to learn is just that you haven't mastered the skill of learning itself yet. Because trying to learn difficult things like coding without actually first learning the skill of learning is sort of like trying to build the roof of the house before like building the foundation of the house. Like, you might have the best roof in the world, but if you don't have a foundation for your house, it's just gonna like fall down. And the biggest problem with this, there's a massive problem with the way you've probably been learning your entire life, because the way you're taught to learn at school is not actually the best way at all. You're probably wasting a massive amount of time just learning the completely wrong way. And this is what I see with most people. So in this video, I'm gonna give you a solution. I'm gonna give you a system to apply to learn any skill that you want. There's three steps to my process, and I've applied this to not only just learning to code, I've applied this to learning languages. So I hope that these systems that have really worked for me can work for you as well. And I highly suggest that you pay close attention to this video, because if you master this freaking skill, it could be the most important thing that you have mastered in your entire life. So let's get started. So the first step is to get better at the skill of focus. You need to be able to sit down at your desk and focus on one thing for an extended period of time, ideally at least 1 to 2 hours. And there's a couple of strategies to do that. First of which is to make sure you don't eat carbs before your work session. There's a thing that happens when you eat a load of carbs, like these fast carbs, like, you know, pasta, sugar, bread, these kinds of things, they spike your blood sugar. But what also happens is that after like, I don't know, half an hour, their blood sugar goes down and it like crashes. That's where you get these like carb crashes that people talk about. And it's during these crashes, like usually after your meal, that it's gonna be very, very difficult to focus.
What are you looking at?
But the thing is, if your meals are filled with these fast carbs that cause these blood sugar spikes and crashes, it's going to be very, very hard for you to focus, because in that kind of state, your brain is just going to have a very hard time focusing. So that's why when I go through phases, when I want to learn a lot and I want to focus a lot, I stick to a very low fast carb diet, or what's called like a slow carb diet. And in general, at least for me, I find that when I'm fasted, so in the morning, my focus is up, because when you have eaten a lot, even if it's not as much carbs, like, you're just gonna be full. And I'm sure you know that feeling of just being stuffed, it's just being full and like lethargic after a big meal. It's gonna make it much, much harder to focus and for your brain to work as hard as it needs to actually learn. Another thing is that exercise and daily exercise, like, first of all, should be a daily habit for you anyway, but this also helps with focus. This is a thing I learned when I was recently listening to an episode of the Huberman Lab podcast. Essentially, after exercising, there's around a 2-hour window where your focus is going to be elevated. This is also a useful time for you to place a work session. But this is what I've now started doing. Every time after working out, I make sure that I have nothing planned afterward. And the thing I do for the next 2 hours after my workout session is going to be a work block or a learning block. Again, allows us to work with our body rather than against our body by strategically placing our work sessions in the moments when focus is at its maximum. And the third strategy to improve your focus is going to be meditation. Focus at the end of the day is just like a muscle. Like, you can train the muscle to get better at the skill of focusing if you haven't mastered it yet. Basically, you just want to sit down for an extended period of time and try to just think of nothing, and you will see, especially if you're one of those people who just scrolls TikTok whose focus is like completely destroyed, it's going to be very, very difficult for you to do that. And the longer you're able to do that, and the more you do that on a daily basis, your skill of focus is going to start improving. Because a lot of the times, even if we were able to focus, we don't want to, because we find studying to be boring or hard work and things like that. And I used to feel that as well. So I came up with this like strategy to essentially trick my brain into wanting to learn. So let me explain that. Okay, so what do you think it is that we're always willing to spend time playing video games, but we're never really willing, or we never really feel like spending time studying? Probably because to us and to most of us, playing video games is fun, like it's cool to play and things like that, but learning is not fun. It feels like something that we have to do rather than something that we want to do. So then as a consequence, if we could just make learning more fun, we would want to do it more, right? And then we would be able to do it more because we would want to do it. And that is, like, from the research and from what I've learned about learning, the biggest thing about everything and just getting things done is that if you can just make the activity more fun, we can make ourselves want to do it more. So here are the ways that I have found to make learning more fun. Again, this is gonna sound a bit weird and might sound a bit controversial even, but I think we all have the ability to just choose to believe that whatever we're doing is fun. Like, let me explain. Like, when you're playing some video game, like I used to play these games where you had to like collect these trophies or like these, complete all these quests and all of this, I didn't always feel like doing it. Like, probably if you're used to playing like shooter games or FIFA or something, when you lose, you're probably not loving the experience, but you still choose to keep playing. So I really spent a long time thinking about why that is. And I just came to the conclusion that we enjoy video games because we choose to enjoy them. We just choose to have the belief that a video game is a fun activity, something that we want to do, so we keep doing it, whereas we choose to believe that learning is not a fun activity, it is not something that we want to do, it's something that we have to do. So what if you just chose to believe that learning is interesting, that learning is simply a game that you're playing where sometimes, yeah, it's difficult, but the difficulty is what leads to that progress. What was found by Richard Feynman, who is one of the most successful learners of all time, is that us humans, we have a natural inclination to want to understand the world. Like, everything we do and our curiosity is always really targeted as understanding how the real world works. And that's actually why I believe that learning some of these more technical slash like abstract topics can be more difficult, because they're sort of removed from the real world. Like, if you're learning loops, that doesn't have an immediate obvious connection to allowing it to understand the real world. That anytime I'm learning something technical or something like abstract that I don't really see the immediate benefit of, I actually take the time to, before going to learn the thing, to place that thing in the context of the real world. What is it that learning this technical thing is going to allow me to understand? What interesting things is it going to allow me to do, or is it going to allow me to understand about the world? For example, if I'm learning loops, which is abstract and like technical and whatever, I try to come up with an example, like a real world use case for the concept of loops, to like make it click better in my brain and to make me more excited to learning. Like, just as a dumb example, when I learn about loops, I might easily see how the concept of loops could be used, for example, to loop through a list of transactions and convert the currency, which could be something that I'd want to build in a finance application that I might want to build. Another example, like data structures and algorithms, is something that people often find like boring and dull and something that they don't want to learn. And I felt this. So when I was learning data structures and algorithms, I took the time to really understand, okay, why are computer scientists actually learning data structures and algorithms? Like, it turns out that faster algorithms contribute more to allowing us to improve the performance of all of our applications than all the improvements in hardware in total. So after I learned that, I understood the reason why learning algorithms is an interesting thing, because I realized that it would allow me to understand why some applications run faster than others. It would allow me to understand how we as humans are able to create these amazing programs that do all these things. This is related to the broader idea of the broader way I essentially live my life, which is making my life into this exploration. Everything I do, everything I learn on a daily basis is just targeted at the goal of improving my own video game character in this game of life, like unlocking new levels. Like, learning something like programming fundamentals, which is this one topic, is going to unlock 10 topics, or at least these 10 areas of software development that we might now be able to learn using these things. So that is how we learn about focus. That is how we actually trick ourselves to want to learn things. But here's where we get to the part where you actually start learning better when you are learning. The problem I have with the way we learn at schools is very what I call test-focused learning. Schools encourage you to learn in such a way that you will pass a test. But the problem with school tests are that they don't really test the thing that actually matters. So tell me if this ever happened to you. You had a test coming off, or a math test or whatever at school. You crammed for it 3 days. You did pretty well at the test, but then a week later, you had no idea and you didn't even remember anything. I was a really, really good student at school. Like, I would always get these really high grades, but then like a month later, I wanted to try to remember something that I had done in a test. I could not remember anything. But the issue with schools is that they try to make you remember all of these things. So you come up with these rules to like memorize things, which is completely useless when it comes to actual real world understanding. And the bigger problem with this is that now, like maybe you're teaching yourself to code, you still wire your brain in this way to optimize for memorization. So you go through some lessons and some course and you try to remember all the functions and all the methods. You completely ignore the idea and you just try to memorize the details because that's what your brain is primed to do. And this is the massive problem and the massive mistake that people do. So here is how you fix that. First of all, when you're going through any course, don't try to memorize anything. Go through the entire thing and at no point try to memorize anything. Okay, the next day after you've learned something, you do what I call the explain to mom test. You essentially imagine that your mom asks you to explain that thing to them, which forces you to explain it in a very conceptual level. And it actually forces you to really, really understand when you're not able to hide behind having memorized some keywords or some syntax or whatever. And in general, you wanna make your brain work really hard, because the way your brain works is that the harder it has to work, better the learning is gonna be, because your brain sort of understands, like, if you're trying to work really hard to remember something or to like use something, it's going to then force itself to like build that thing into the fabric of your brain or whatever the neurons work. And this is why learning through application or learning by doing is so effective, because I mean, you actually have to go out there and build something using loops. So if I gave you the task, you then actually have to understand loops to be able to understand how to do that. The fact that you have memorized the syntax of loops is not going to help you. And that is what we're trying to do in the first place anyway, right? We're trying to learn something to be able to use it in a real world context and to actually do something real with it. Just try to do things much earlier than you think that you can. So even before you fully learn something, give yourself a challenge where you know you would have to use that thing. So for example, building like a full-fledged web application before you even learn the web development, and then figure out what would be the first step that you need to do. It's probably just getting started with Django or something like your web framework. And through immediately applying it to a real project, you actually learn the process of getting started with Django, because your brain is so much more primed to learning when you actually applying it rather than just trying to memorize it in some unrealistic scenario. I'm sorry, just because you've gone through 5 courses doesn't mean that you know how to code, but you can literally just go and build one application from scratch and learn the steps along the way. And after you do that, you will know how to code because you have actually done something with code and your brain will have internalized these things through doing it. And then after that, if you want to learn the theory after you have already tried to apply, because it will make so much more sense after you have actually tried to apply these things first and you've realized that you have these knowledge deficiencies which you can now go and fill. That is how you want to learn. If you want to actually learn things, you need to make your brain work hard, and it's uncomfortable. And that is the biggest problem and the biggest mistake people make, that they're not willing to go the extra mile. They're not willing to put in the effort to really, really work hard because it's uncomfortable.
And oh, I need to be comfortable and this and that. Like,
learning difficult things is hard. If you expected this video to tell you something else, like, I'm sorry, you can dislike the video, I guess. If you just do these 3 things of mastering your focus, making learning fun, and understanding that you need to work hard to actually get results and apply things, you will get results. But the thing is that it's really, really difficult to apply these things and to keep all of these things in mind consistently for a very long period of time. And so to do that, you also need to build the right habits. And so if you want to learn more, I actually just released my new module, Pro Programmers Mindset and Productivity, inside of my full program, Python Developer Masterclass. So for those of you who already bought my full masterclass, it's now available to you and you can find it inside of the course. And for those of you who haven't, if you are interested inside of the program, my goal is to teach you from scratch all the skills that you need to become a real developer, which is not just the technical skills. There's a lot of things to be said about their mindsets and the character traits that you will need to embody as a real developer. And there's a lot of skills that you will need, for example, when it comes comes to building your CV and actually getting hired, because it would suck to get to the point where you learn all these skills but you still can't get hired because you don't know how to apply for jobs strategically, how to actually impress companies, how to build your resume, how to interview. So that's why I've also included sections in the course that specifically teach you these skills as well. But because for right now, some of the modules are not out yet, so I'm going to be making modules on Python web development, on object-oriented programming, which is going to be the next ones that's coming out. I do still have the program heavily discounted from the full price that it's going to be. So if you're interested, the link is going to be down below right there, but the price will keep going up as time goes on. So make sure you don't miss out on this price point. With that, I hope you got value out of this video. If you did, I would appreciate a like down below, and make sure you remember that you can do a lot more than you think. I will see you in the next video.